Hi, I'm Cyaneink, and this time I have another of these Fyling Tiger art supply videos. I actually opened this before because I was thinking my camera was filming, but it wasn't. I haven't filmed for a long time, so that's why I'm making this here. But yeah, basic acrylic painting set that has these teeny tiny pots of paints and horrible plastic. Bristly brush. And it's got like 2 to 3 euros, I'm not sure. And this canvas is too from Fyling Tiger. And I'm not sure if it's small enough for this teeny tiny page, because I have afraid that these aren't like going to last for that long. And now I'm going to got the water cup and let's get these paints like trying out how this works. And welcome to the time lapse. And I know this paints were like super hard to open. It's ridiculous how tight these little lids were, and it was really hard to open. Also, not trying to like spill paint everywhere. Definitely, if you try to give this some kid, she or he would never get this open. It was so hard. Like, I don't even know how. And also, these teeny tiny pots were only half full. Like, there isn't like tiny enough already. So, yeah, I had some kind of idea. I knew that I will run out of maybe paint, but I would try to do something. But paints itself were half decent. The black was opaque, but the blue wasn't opaque, and also light blue was really transparent, but that's really common for like bad acrylic paints. Also, thing I noticed, this don't dry that fast. That was one thing that really made me surprised, because usually acrylics dry like lightning fast. This didn't, and that's why I smudged the black somewhere, but it also makes blending surprisingly easy. So I'm not sure what to think about these paints. And here you can see me again struggling with opening the paint pot. I decided to leave those in because that gives quite great idea how hard these were open. I think this would be really handy like if you're like traveling and want to paint, because this was so tiny, like with sketchbook. But these are so hard to open, but at least they don't leak, I think. And I have a plan for repurposing these little paint pots after this video, because I'm not going to keep these acrylics. Also, brush were horrible. It is that horrible black bristle brush that you get with every super cheap paint set, and it's just horrible to use. It leaves streaks and it doesn't work well with any paints. And for canvas, it was semi-decent for cheap canvas. It has like really prominent view like they usually have, and I didn't go to gesso it because it would be cheating. But yeah, it was pretty gesso it. It's paintable, I would say, but not anything super smooth. Also, I'm not sure about the quality. There isn't like, usually when you buy canvas, even if it's like cheap one, there's those little slots on the corners when you can hammer those. I'm not sure what the word is in English, but those little things that like go there and expand a little bit the frame and make the canvas more tight. And here you can see me. Well, I haven't been used to that. I have keeping my curtains open, so the sun was casting in and making these huge shadows. And now lighting is like really, really off. And sorry about that. I haven't been recording for a long time, and this video has been like full of mistakes now. But yeah, hopefully that isn't too bothering. And at this point, I decided I will open some of these pots like beforehand, because they were so hard to open. It was just ridiculous how tight they were. And then I decided to draw a bunch of little jellyfishes that I have in my mind, and this was just horrible. The brush was so large and it couldn't carry that much paint. I couldn't paint any details, and also it like finally distributed the paints like only left like big clumps or not anything at all on canvas. Definitely not my favorite brush, but yeah, they work it out. I applied like really thick layers for these ones because these lighter colors weren't opaque enough. Which is a really common problem for like yellows and oranges, at least in my like regular acrylic paints, they are not like opaque enough. So here is like really prominent. And also a little bit about color selection. First day, of course, I have this like really nice bright yellow screen jellyfishes. But there's only one green, and it's not yellowish green, it's bluish green. And that's not mixed very bright yellowish green. And also I didn't want to mix this paint because there were so little to begin with. But there were many reds. I think there are 4 reds. 2 of them were like shockingly pink. And it was just, I don't know why they were selecting these colors. They were really, there was no browns or anything. They were just like bright kids colors. And also the colors were really close together, like this. Other of the red and the orange, they were almost the same. There weren't any violets, I think. No, I was thinking maybe there was, but yeah, there isn't any violets. They were like really odd color selection. So I'm not sure what they were thinking when they put this set together. And also, one thing really bothered me. This is really nitpicking. But they weren't in color order or like in spectrum order. They were like everywhere. Pinks were, it was just horrible mess. And there was this light, really pretty light blue, but not like light green or any other pastel colors. It was really odd. But yeah, what you can expect from like €2 paint set. Yeah. And I'm almost finishing this up. And there's the shadows going because, I'm so bad at recording videos now. So thanks for watching and leave the like if you like this and leave the dislike if you didn't like. And leave the comment below, do you have tried these cheap acrylics? I have seen these like in supermarkets or those kind of stores. If you do, leave the comment below how you like them. And also if you have tried these Tiger ones. Hope I see you in my next video. Bye!